Okay, in this video we want to extend the notion of a cyclic subgroup and look at the notion of a cyclic group. So we say G is a cyclic group if every element in G can be written in terms of a single generator. So we generally write it like that. So notice that's the cyclic subgroup of G generated by G. And if that coincides with the whole group, then we say that whole group is cyclic. And here I'm saying for some G in G, and in fact, a group can have a bunch of different generators kind of depending on its structure. So the first thing that we want to prove is that every cyclic group is abelian. Then we'll look at some examples of cyclic groups and non-cyclic groups, and then we'll look at the subgroups of a cyclic group. So let's suppose that G is cyclic. So in other words, we can write G as generated by G like this. And then let's take X and Y in G. And so notice that means that X equals G to the M and Y equals G to the N for some M and N in the integers, because that's what it means to come from this cyclic group. But now let's notice that here, X times Y is the same thing as G to the M times G to the N, which is G to the M plus N, because we have exponent rules in the group rule. But now that's equal to G to the N plus M, because the operation happening in this exponent is just addition of integers, and we know that's commutative. But now that's exactly G to the N times G to the M, which is Y times X. So look at what we have. We have X times Y equals Y times X. In other words, our group operation is commutative, which is exactly what we need to show that our group is abelian. Okay, so I'll clean up the board and we'll look at some examples. Okay, so now we want to look at some examples and non-examples of cyclic groups. So first of all, for the examples, so notice that Z is a cyclic group, and it's the cyclic group generated by the element 1, and that's because here our operation is addition, and so that means here everything is written in terms of n times 1 for n in the integers, but that just recovers the definition of the integers like immediately. Okay, good. Now, what about Zn? Notice that's also going to be a cyclic group, and that's also generated by the number 1. This actually has some more generators as well, which we'll see later. Okay, so for our next example, let's look at U6. So this is made up of all numbers between 1 and 6 that are relatively prime to 6. So here we have, this is 1, we can't count 2 or 3 or 4, and then 5. Great, and now notice this is clearly cyclic. It's generated by 5, because we have 5 to the first power is 5, 5 squared is 25, which is 1. Okay, good. Let's look at another example like this, maybe U9. Notice that everything relatively prime to 9 is given by 1, 2, 4, 5, 7, and 8. Good. And now notice that this is generated by 2. And so let's see if we can check that real quick. So 2 to the 0 is 1. 2 to the 1 is 2. 2 squared is 4. So that's easy. 2 cubed is equal to 8. That's also easy. And then 2 to the 4th power is equal to 16. But 16 is the same thing as 7 mod 9. And then finally, 2 to the 5th power is 32. But 32 is the same thing as 5 mod 9. So we have achieved every element of U9 from powers of 2. Okay, so let's look at some non-examples. We actually get a bunch of non-examples for free, and that's all non-abelian groups. And that's because we just proved that all cyclic groups were abelian. So that means all non-abelian groups are not cyclic. So maybe it would be interesting to look at some non-examples that are abelian just for interest. And notice we could take things like Z2 cross Z2. So notice this is going to be not cyclic, and it's also abelian. So this is made up of 4 elements. So we have 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, and then finally 1, 1. So if we look at the cyclic subgroup of each of those elements, we'll see that we never achieve the whole group. And we can do that really quick. So we look at the cyclic subgroup of 1, 0. And notice if you do 1, 0 plus 1, 0, you're going to get 0, 0. And then we can have the cyclic subgroup of all of the other guys like that. And each of those only contains two elements, themselves and the identity. And then finally down here, we have the subgroup only containing the identity. And notice in this picture, we've looked at all of the cyclic subgroups of this group Z2 cross Z2, and none of them are the entire group. So what this means is that this is not a cyclic group. All right, good. This is a good place to end this video.